my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be always acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our God, and our Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning, everybody. Compassion, the last word for August 2021. Dearly beloved, this is the end of the month where each year the Church places special emphasis on compassion and entreats each one of us to explore the depth of our compassionate response situations for which we have no human response. August is also Women's Month, highlighting the necessary reality and importance of our focus on compassion and women. But this is an essential fact the whole year round, of course. Well known is the statement ascribed to Atticus, you never really understand a person until you walk a mile in his shoes. Many people, especially those of us in the social caring ministries, believe that this is true. And it is. It points to an empathetic understanding of the plight of the other. However, in my experience, it goes deeper. I often deal with bereaved people and families, and the depth of their sorrow is such that whilst one can respond with empathy, each person's loss is unique to them. And I believe that is important. Many people lose a loved one, but only you lose your loved one. So we can enter so far into their sadness, and we should, but there is a space which belongs to the one whose sadness is the deepest. What this means for me, and I hope typifies my role as a priest, is yes, to genuinely care. But it goes further than that. We need to prayerfully care. It is God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, who brings healing and wholeness. And we, each one of us, become a channel for the work of God. Why is prayer so important? Our definitive response to all that is wrong in the world? There's an unconditional bond between us as human beings with God. In John 15 it says, he no longer calls us servants, but calls us friends, an invitation to a deeper relationship with God. God is the creator of humankind, and what is more, God invites us to be co-creators of a perfect world. We can never be God, but we can follow him so closely that our world is changed because we are godly people. Prayer strengthens our bond with God. It is our God language. God understands everything which we do not. Even if we don't know what to say or what burdens our heart, things that are too great to be put into words, the Holy Spirit makes intercession for us, because our heart is known to God. Prayer encourages us to draw closer to God. Prayer strengthens the bond between God and us. Simply put, God helps his people in trouble. He can do no other because he loves us unconditionally. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. If we move into secular events, we only need to look at the past week to accept the truth of this. There have been many sad events. Think of the gruesome murder of Noselo Ntebeni, her body dismembered by her boyfriend. She was yet another victim of gender-based violence. One young woman took off her mask when she was being interviewed and said that she was doing it deliberately because she's not scared of COVID. She is only scared of men. We cannot just look on and shake our heads. The young woman who died was a final year student. Think of the sacrifices she and her family have made to get her to that point. Think of the loss to a country which so badly needs qualified young professionals. So yes, we can and should genuinely care. But more so as people made in the image of God, and seeing a young person made in the image of God die in such a callous way, we should prayerfully care against the forces of darkness, in this case, the historic scourge of patriarchy in our society. Think of the murder of Lupita Diokaran last Monday. She stood in the gap for all right-minded people, for South Africa, in fact, when she became a whistleblower, and her gain for that was her gruesome murder. She left behind a young daughter who needs her, a family who loves her, and colleagues who respected her integrity and selflessness. We can never truly understand that pain, but that doesn't mean we cannot genuinely care and show compassion, and even more than that, prayerfully care, again, against the forces of darkness which seek only to destroy. Think of the situation in Afghanistan, people rushing to Kabul airport, running down the runway, trying to hold on to the wings of a plane as it was taking off. And more especially, think of the bomb blast which killed 100 people on Thursday, both Afghans and American military soldiers. We watch the scenes playing out on our TV screens. We watch crowds of people trying to get into the airport compound. We saw the expressions on the faces of little children as they too ran, trying to keep up with their parents, or being carried screaming because of the things they are too young to understand. Some people, onlookers, would find it too hard to share those scenes. They would switch off their TV because they can't internalize them. But that doesn't mean that they don't care. And again, we all need to genuinely care. And as believers, we need to prayerfully care and to decry the forces of darkness who unleash their terror on innocent people and children in Afghanistan. And what can we learn from the compassion bestowed on us by others? We as white people in this country owe a huge debt of gratitude to black women who chose to work as carers for our families, our children, our elderly. My housekeeper, who has worked for my family for over 30 years, cried so much when she heard my husband was ill and had to go to hospital. And she said, "But I love him. I love all of you." You cannot adequately pay a person for that level of love and care. In fact, money is not a relevant currency in that respect. I conducted a memorial service for a 93-year-old woman this week. She died of pneumonia and COVID. She lived on Runchy's estate, and she needed carers for the last 15 years as she struggled with Alzheimer's disease. She has three children, but only one daughter living in this country, and because of COVID, the daughter was not allowed to visit her. So she depended totally on her carers. These women not only cared for her, but they loved her, and they came to her service this week to show their love and their compassion for her. No amount of money delivers that degree of compassion. So against these terrible situations which assail our communities and we see on our media, we need a fresh understanding of compassion. We need to engage at a level which goes beyond sadness and shaking our heads, even expressing anger. We do not have the human capacity to project our caring, even our prayers, into a space where they become truly effective without the help of God. The prophet Jeremiah said, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and I will heal their land." And in the book of Revelation, it stated, "The smoke of the incense which came with the prayers of the saints ascended up before God out of an angel's hand." And unless I have misunderstood, there is somewhere else in the book of Revelation a moment in time, it doesn't actually say how much time, but the heavens are silent for a period of time every day whilst the prayers of the faithful are heard. So we need to pray genuinely, deeply, and as St. Paul said, pray without ceasing. I want to end by reminding you of two of my favorite Old Testament both women. Remember Ruth, who chose to stay with her mother-in-law, Naomi, when Naomi was destitute and hopeless. Never will I leave you. Never will I forsake you, Ruth said. Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you stay, I will stay. They will be my people, and I will stay with you. And this week, Michelle reminded us of the other one, quoting from the book of Esther, that God's protection comes with our proactive response to divine prompting. Do not suppose that you will be the one to escape persecution. No, if you persist in remaining silent at such a time as this, deliverance will come from another quarter, but you and your family will perish. Perhaps you have come for a time, just a time, such as this. My friends, you and I, all of us, have come for a time such as this. I'm convinced of it. The absolute power of prayer and the depth of our prayers is a reflection of our true compassionate response in our current circumstances. We, men and women, you and me, every person, because we are all made in the image of God, we were made for a time such as this. Amen.
Amen.
So let us pray. Lord God, help us to hear your heartbeat. We know kindness is not enough. We need to hear the heartbeat of those in need, those living on the edge of society, the abused, the outcast, the poor, the unemployed, the sick, the dying. Help us to link their heartbeat to yours, which is so much more powerful than we can ever achieve ourselves. Be the power of your Holy Spirit. Help each one of us to be a conduit in every situation, as the friends who lowered their sick friend through the roof to be healed by Jesus, by you. Help us to be such a friend. Help us to reach out to others, not with our own heartbeat, but with yours.